you like to use hyperlinks, there's a quick way to create hyperlinks, but there's a problem with it. So I want to link that. I can right click, go link, and then I can go place in this document and find it. The problem is the hyperlink won't follow the cells. So if you insert rows or columns, it won't work. So this is another way to do it. So I've set it up, I've already done a few, but I'm just going to go through the steps. So the first one here is over here. We just need to link to a cell. So this is called unit sales. I'm just going to say equals. And for now, I'm going to go and just click perhaps over there. I'm going to click enter. The trick now is to actually extract from there. So you don't actually care about any of that. You actually want the path. There's a great new function in Excel. It's called formula text. And you'll see all you do is you point at that cell, and instead of giving you what it sees there, it actually looks at the underlying path. We need to remove the equal sign. Now, all of this could be done in one step. I'm going to actually do it individually. So to remove the equal sign, I'm going to use a mid function. And all I'm going to say is look at that cell, start at character number 2, and I'm going to go for 1,000 characters, for example. And then we're going to create the hyperlink. And this is the trick around it. We're going to use a formula actually called hyperlink. And the most important part, we want to point at that path. But if you do that, it's not going to find it. You have to put inverted commas, hash, inverted commas, ampersand, and point at the path. So you'll see what it's done is it's taken that path and just put a hash in front of it. For the friendly name, you could type something, you could say click here. I'm just going to say look at whatever we typed in here. And now when I say okay, creates the hyperlink. Now what's nice is if I click on the hyperlink, it takes me there. And you'll see I've created a whole bunch of others. There's the income statement on that same page lower down, so we can see it there. The reason this works better is because of the way we've set it up here, it'll actually follow these cells. So I've decided I actually don't want everything on one sheet. So I'm actually going to cut Control X, the income statement and balance sheet, to a new sheet. So I'm going to put it here. Let's look what's happened to our index. So the formulas here have adjusted. So now when we click on income statement, it actually takes us to that new sheet. So using the hyperlink formula makes it much easier for firstly to set up and also for it to follow where the actual cell is you want to link to.